So it's been a while since I've talked about the batch rename tool in the Finder on the Mac. And I still get a lot of questions about this. It's probably because for years there wasn't such a tool. You had to use more advanced techniques to rename bunches of files at a time. And it was added several years ago, and people still have old information or look up old pages that say you can't do this on the Mac. And you actually can do it, and it's pretty easy. If you try to find a way to rename lots of files by looking through the menu items, you're not going to find it because you need to select multiple files for it to appear. Under File, you've got Rename, and if I select a single file, you can see I can rename that file. And if I select multiple files, I'm going to use the Shift key to select all of these. If I go and I look there, you can see that changes to rename 6 items. So that's where it's hiding. There is no menu item that's always there that says Batch Rename or something like that. So let me select that, and it brings up this little tool here. And I have several different things that I can do with it. I can replace text, I can add text, or I can format. So the simplest thing to do is replace text. So in this case, every file name has the word project in it. So I'm going to, it's called Project A, and maybe I want to add a space to that. So I'll have it search for Project A, and I'm going to replace it with Project Space A. And it's going to give me an example here. So it's going to pick one of the files out, the first one that it finds that actually will change, and shows you what it looks like. So it's going to add that space there. And I hit Rename, it's going to rename all the files. So you can see it added that space there between Project and A. I could have renamed it something completely different, like Work A or Project Alpha, something like that. So it's pretty easy to rename things. And one of the cool things is it doesn't rename files that don't have that in it. So for instance here, if I duplicate this file and I have this one called Notes 2. So I have Notes and Notes 2. If I select all of these with Command A and I say rename 7 files, but I want you to replace the text Notes with something else, Info, and I hit Rename, and it only renamed those 2 files because it didn't find that in any of the other ones. So that's handy to know. The other things that you can do is you can, instead of replacing text, you can add text. So you can say, I want to add some text to the beginning. So I'll add like AAA space before it, or I can add it after the name, hit rename, and it puts it all there. If I make a mistake, it's pretty easy to use undo to undo them all. But I could also go and just do another rename. So I can say, well, I don't want that. I don't want AAA space before the name. I can just replace AAA space with nothing, and it will take all that away. Now your other options are format. With format you can do all sorts of things. For instance, you could add a name and an index, name and a counter, name and a date. So I can take all these and say name and index, and I want it to be before the name, and I'll just say file and start the numbers at 1. And you can see it's going to go and put a number and then the name that I gave, file, and rename all the files like that. It's handy if you have, say, an entire set of photos and you just want to get rid of the names because they don't mean anything and you just want to have numbered 1 through whatever. So you could do that pretty easily. I would do after name, and then it would be called like photo 1. And you can see photo 1 through 7.